Since we launched RHEL 9 3 years ago, the world has completely changed. Now we're talking about AI transformation, quantum computing, and security threats that sound like something from a sci-fi plot. The operating system is so critical, and so I want to tell you about three things that I think are really cool in RHEL 10. So the first thing I want to talk to you about is the Linux skills gap. It's not new. It's been around since the early days of Unix to Linux migrations and even bringing Windows admins over to work on Linux. The idea is it's 2 a.m., you get into some kind of problem and you're getting into territory where you're not super familiar with the commands. And you have a couple different options. You can stay in the terminal, look at obscure man pages that have strange command line options that you might not even fully understand. Another option is you can go out on the internet, search around on a forum, and then hope that whatever you paste into the terminal actually doesn't break things. None of those are great options. That's why we built RHEL Lightspeed. RHEL Lightspeed is an LLM-based tool that you invoke from the command line. In fact, you just type the letter C and then you ask it a question. It's beautiful because it reduces uncertainty at both build time when you're building out core builds and at runtime when you're troubleshooting something at 2 a.m. The second thing we wanted to address with RHEL 10 is infrastructure complexity. Imagine you have a fleet of servers, 100,000 servers with 50 different personalities. That means you still need to update 100,000 different servers. With RHEL Image Mode, we simplify this and change this. You focus on just the 50 different personalities, build an image for each one, and then deploy that out to the entire fleet as you need to. It's a single command to update and roll back, and that simplifies management, increases security, and lowers cognitive load. The third thing I want to talk to you about is shifting left and making better decisions at build time. Today with Red Hat Insights, you can monitor performance, security, and cost of your running fleet of servers. But with the new capabilities coming in RHEL 10, we're actually shifting that left and giving you access to augmented information at build time. For example, with a combination of Insights Image Builder and RHEL Digital Roadmap, we can give you access to lifecycle information for how long pieces of software in RHEL are supported, as well as roadmap items that are coming down the pipe, and specific release notes tailored to your fleet of servers. There's a lot of hidden costs for infrastructure teams at build time. And with Insights Image Builder and RHEL Digital Roadmap, we'll be able to reduce the time and effort necessary to plan out new versions of RHEL. With Red Hat Enterprise Linux 10, we're not only upgrading the operating system, we're bringing an upgrade to the user's life.